Good evening, everybody. Welcome. Happy New Year. I've tried to extend the holiday season. It's a very short meeting, so we can get to the presentation. Thank you all very much. And now we have... Oh, hello, there you go. Welcome.
Can you hear me? So I'm going to walk through the slides quickly so I can reserve some time if you guys have questions. I know everyone has different questions and anything you want to talk about. First slide over here. Basically, the point is, while 63% of high school graduates are not college ready, 40% of Harvard comes from specialized high schools, and 37% of McAuliffe students So the point is, it's really important to prepare your child from a very early age to ensure their future success. And every one of you here has done that because they're on college. And the next step is you need to help them get to the best high school they should get to. And some of the best high schools in New York City are the specialized high schools. So, next slide. About the SHSAT. The SHSAT stands for Specialized High School Admission Test. This is the one test that all 8th graders, the beginning of their 8th grade year, take to get into one of the 8 specialized high schools that New York City has to offer. They don't look at anything else. They just look at this test score. So this is currently the sole criteria. It takes place at the end of October. So if you are a 7th grader, it would be about 9 months from now. This is when they will take the test. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
it's just throwing random stuff in there and it will throw people off a little bit, but they are using it to help them make better tests in the future. Then it used to be 5 multiple choice answers, now it's 4. The verbal section used to have this two crazy things called logic reasoning and spinal paragraphs, which nobody has learned anywhere, and it's very difficult. And in order to make it more fair, they changed it. And now they changed it into revising and editing questions, which is grammar based, which is still something that people don't really learn anywhere. But at least it's a little bit more of a part of the statewide and all that. So it's a kind of grammar and written error question. And then the math section used to be all multiple choice, and now there's a new question where you have to come up with an answer and write down the answer. So that's what the new test looks like. The second part in here shows you how to score. So there's 57 math questions on the test. 10 of them are field questions, which means that they don't count, but you don't know which ones they are. So eventually you get 47 lost score points if you get everything right. And then that's how it converts to a 0 to 400 scale. You can get 350 or 250, etc. on one section. The ELA section has 20 of the revising and editing questions, 37 of the reading comprehension questions, also 10 of the trivia questions.
What are the questions?
Experimental questions that they throw in there that don't eventually count.
Oh,
right, but if students don't know which ones they are, so they still have to try. So there's also 47 law points, which also converts to somewhere between 0 and 400 scale. So you can get 250 in one section, 250 in another, together that's 500. 500 doesn't make sense then, but it makes perfect sense. That's how those cutoff scores come about. I'm going to pause for a second. Problems. And then once they not wasting 15 minutes on one question is really, really important. And also, accuracy. Everybody makes careless mistakes. And these are the mistakes that really kill you because you're like, I know how to do this. I also know how to do this. I just, you know, add it all. It's a practice all. So catching those accuracy issues and maintaining their speed, that's sort of the last step. Once they learn the fundamentals, figure out how to do it together, then we work on the accuracy and speed.
Thank you.
harder than your practice exams, et cetera, et cetera. And generally, our math is a little bit harder than the real math. Our ELA is about the same.
So in the summer, it's Monday to Friday, 3 hours a day. And what is the day like? Do we take the practice exam? Do we homework every night?
No, so Monday to Friday, yeah. So Friday is for exam day. Monday to Thursday is classes. The 3 hours is an hour and 25 minutes of math, an hour and 25 minutes of reading. And we teach all these concepts that they're going to do. So it's all taught. It's not just practice. They should have